Yesterday at Google I.O., Google announced the public availability of GoogleBard, or at least that they're rolling out GoogleBard to 180 countries, so depending on where you live in the world, you already might have access to it, or you might soon have access to it. And therefore now with GoogleBard, and with Microsoft Bing Chat, and of course with ChatGPT that started it all, you now have the choice between three really capable and great AI chatbots that can help you in your day-to-day life. And as a side note, in that big ChatGPT course that we launched yesterday, ChatGPT The Complete Guide, we already added a complete section where we also take a closer look at Google Bard and Microsoft Bing Chat, and also the Bing Chat integration in the Microsoft Edge browser, so that you can really use these AI chatbots in the best possible way. And what you learn in this course about prompt engineering and so on, of course, will also be relevant for these other chatbots. But in this video here, I simply want to give you a brief comparison of these three chatbots, show you which different features they offer, and of course also show you which chatbot produces the best results. So let's start with ChatGPT. ChatGPT is really powerful and can be used for generating blog posts, tweets, drafting emails, summarizing text, translating text, writing code, and many other things as well. Now to use it, you simply need to create an account, which you can do for free. And that's all. You can get started right away thereafter. You can insert your prompt and get back a result by ChatGPT. And since it's a chat, you can of course also send follow-up messages, and ChatGPT will take the existing chat history into account, and ChatGPT will go ahead and generate a new response. Now there is a certain limit regarding the amount of context it can take into account, but it's a quite generous limit, and therefore that's of course one of the amazing features of ChatGPT and of these AI chatbots in general, that they take the history into account. Now ChatGPT becomes even better if you upgrade to Plus, because the Plus version, which is a paid version, gives you access to more and better AI models. For example, here it generated a way more detailed and elaborate blog post, and it also got that email right and did not just give me a summary, but actually wrote an email with that summary to my colleague. But of course, as mentioned, we don't just have ChatGPT. We, for example, also have Google Bard, Google's answer to ChatGPT, you could say. Now, Google Bard might not be available in all areas of the world yet, but it soon should be, and you do need a Google account in order to use it. And once you are logged in, you're greeted by a typical chat interface. Now, Google Bard also has this updates area here, where it tells you what changed, which can be a nice place to stay updated. But the most important question, of course, is how it performs compared to ChatGPT. And one difference you'll notice when you start using Google Bard is that it can take slightly longer to get started, but it then gives you the entire response in one single step. You don't have to wait for it. It's not generated step by step. Instead, boom, it's there instantly. And you can also choose between different drafts, and these draft versions are also available instantly. You don't have to wait for them to be generated, and that of course allows you to pick the draft you personally like most, which can of course be a very useful feature, since if you don't like the initial draft, you don't have to send the same prompt again and wait for a new response to be generated, which can take quite some time with ChatGPT, especially when using their latest model, which is the best model but also the slowest. Now regarding the quality of the responses, I guess the responses here look all right. I think the ChatGPT responses looked slightly more elaborate, but that will of course always also depend on what specifically you were asking for. It is worth noting though that of course here we also have a chat, and we therefore can send follow-up messages. And just like ChatGPT, Google Bard tries to take the entire chat history into account. It should do that, but as you can see here, for example, it fails for me, and it gives me some random email draft instead. Now, in the past, I also had scenarios where instead it gave me just the summary without an email, though there it at least gave me alternative drafts that gave me a summary in an email. So to me, Google Bard right now at least definitely doesn't seem to be as helpful and polished as ChatGPT is. Now, it's also worth noting that Google Bard also has access to the internet, or to be precise, to web search, to search search results. So you can, for example, ask Bard for the weather or for any other data that might need a web search to get the correct result, and Bard will go ahead and do that web search under the hood and give you a response that takes those web search results into account without explicitly telling you that it performed a search. But at least here I can confirm that this data here or this output here is correct. And ChatGPT, for example, is not able to do that, at least if used without plugins. With plugins, a feature which is not available to everyone yet, for example, I don't have access to it, it would be able to also search the web. So this likely is a capability ChatGPT will gain in the near future, but at least right now, where I'm recording this, it's not able to search the web yet. Now, last but not least, we also have Microsoft Bing, which of course is a search engine, but they also added an AI chatbot to their page, to the search engine, basically. And if you're logged into a Microsoft account, which is a prerequisite, on the Bing.com starting page, you should have this input area, which does not just allow you to ask questions, for which it then could perform a web search, but which can also be used for more complex requests, like here, where I wanted to write me a blog post about the rise of AI. And it then uses its AI capabilities to generate such a blog post. Though interestingly enough, Microsoft Bing actually uses the same models, the same GPT models, as ChatGPT does. Probably with a different fine-tuning and configuration. It's hard to tell from the outside, but in general, the same technology. Nonetheless, what's interesting about Microsoft Bing is that just like Google Bard, it's also able to search the web, and it incorporates those web search results into the responses it generates. And it even marks the parts that are coming from web search in its response, which is pretty useful, something Bard is not doing, at least not right now. Here in Bing, I can see which information is coming from which source, and that of course can help me confirm the validity and correctness of the generated content. Because that is something you should be aware of for all these chatbots. They can produce wrong results, and they will do that in a very confident way. So you should always validate the responses they give you. And here for Microsoft Bing, that might, for example, be a bit easier because you get these references right inside of the response, allowing you to find out where the information is coming from. Now, with Microsoft Bing, you can also enter chat mode, also right from Bing.com, from its starting page. And then here, you can have the same kind of conversation as you can with Google Bard or ChatGPT. Now, as you can see, and as you could see before as well, unlike Google Bard, it does generate its response step by step, just like ChatGPT. And at least here, for this example, where I requested a blog post, I think it's also fair to say that this response, which I got here, is worse than what I got from Google Bard or ChatGPT. This might be a nice summary, but it isn't really a blog post. Now, of course, it is a chat though, so you can send follow-up messages. And then like ChatGPT and Google Bard, it should take the entire chat history into account. Though here, for me, in this example, as you can see, just like Google Bard a couple of minutes ago, it actually fails to give me an email with a summary for the blog post. It instead just gives me some generic email. Now, this of course might not always be the case, but it is the case here. And it is a good example that even though Microsoft Bing Chat should be using the same model under the hood as ChatGPT, at least here for me, it doesn't produce results that have the same quality as ChatGPT's results have. Now, one nice additional feature offered by Microsoft Bing is that you can choose between different modes: creative, balanced, and precise. Balanced is the default, but you could, for example, choose creative if you wanted a, guess what, more creative and also often more lengthy response. For example, here in this response it's generating for me, it even includes some formatting, like a big title, a bullet point with some bold text and things like this. And as you can also see, it's definitely a longer blog post than what I got before in balanced mode. It's less focused on giving me a concise summary and instead does what I wanted to do and write me a blog post. So this creative mode can be great for tasks like this. Though I will also say that the danger of incorrect information is a bit higher in that mode. I mean, you should always validate the results, no matter which mode and which chatbot you're using. But in this creative mode, the danger is a bit higher, and therefore you should be extra careful and carefully evaluate the content that was generated, which at least is made a bit easier because it does give you these extra references to the search results it did use for generating this response. Or at least parts of the response. Now, if you do switch to the more precise mode, on the other hand, it is exactly that. It's more precise, it focuses on giving you a short summary, and it's not really made for tasks like like writing a blog post, for example. So instead, this precise mode might be the kind of mode you want to use for research tasks, for example. So therefore, as you can see, all these different AI bots have their strengths and weaknesses. Google Bard and Microsoft Bing incorporate web search results. ChatGPT might soon do that or might soon enable this for everyone, but it's not available yet. On the other hand, ChatGPT, in my experience, after playing around with all these bots for some time, tends to often produce better results. Though it's of course kind of hard to really measure this in an objective way. But I found out that especially when using certain advanced prompting techniques, about which you for example also learn in our ChatGPT course, this complete guide course, ChatGPT often tends to perform a bit better and produce better results. On the other hand, for example for Bing, it's great to have these different modes and to have these references that indicate which data is coming from web search, whereas for Bard, it's great that it's so fast and that we get those responses and those different draft versions almost instantly, which of course makes it more pleasant to use this tool than, for example, ChatGPT, where you might need to wait quite some time until you have the response. Of course, on the other hand, if the ChatGPT response is better, that might be the more important aspect, though. Now, of course, it's also worth mentioning, though, that the best ChatGPT model is only available to paid subscribers, though, and not to everyone, whereas Google Bard and Bing, despite maybe being a bit worse, though, as mentioned, that's kind of hard to tell also, are free to use. You just need a Google or Microsoft account and you're ready to get started. You don't have to pay for them. But in the end, of course, these different bots are all under heavy development and are constantly evolving, so they will all probably just get better and not worse.